It is indeed a good pleasure to be here in the house of the Lord today to celebrate Resurrection Day.
Amen.
Every day we should celebrate Resurrection Day. And we're going to do it today with a baptism as we begin our service. And we're going to also have the Lord's Supper today. So hope that you enjoy the worship. But more than that, I hope you enjoy being with the Lord, meeting with Him, and hearing from Him today. We welcome you here at Sunset Park Baptist Church, and I hope that as we meet together, if you're a guest of ours today, that you will allow one of our ushers to hand you a packet. You would raise your hand if you're one of our guests, and we will recognize you and hand you some information and a gift from our church. It has been a long time since we have observed a baptism here. Praise the Lord that we have an opportunity today to baptize a young man that visited our church, that came and we stayed in contact with and shared with him, and he accepted the Lord as his Savior and waited for this day. But I do want to say this. Thank you, Brother Robert. The water's not hot. Amen. And some of you deacons remember that. It was hot. But it is a good time to see him if you would come.
As Tim's coming for baptism, I'd like to read a portion of Scripture in Acts 2, verse 36. God's Word tells us, therefore, let all the house of Israel know for certain that God has made him both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now, when they have heard this, they were pierced to the heart and said to Peter and to the rest of the apostles, brethren, what shall we do? And Peter said to them, repent and let each of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of our sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For this promise is for you and your children, and for all who are far off, as many as the Lord our God shall call to himself.
Tim, upon your profession of faith in Jesus Christ that you shared with me that Wednesday night, that you shared with Warren and others, we're going to baptize you today, our brother. We'll pray for you. We ask you that you pray for us. All live in the glory of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Heavenly Father, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you, my brother, Brother Tim. Amen.
Amen.
Praises to you, may you be honored and glorified. As we lift up the name of Jesus, succumb to the will and the direction of the Holy Spirit today. May you be pleased with our worship. May it be acceptable in your sight today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. As Miss Martha makes her way up, I wanted to remind you what we bear witness of just this morning. There was a baptism. Anybody remember their time of baptism? This should be a stirring for all of us, because as a family of God, this is what life is all about. If we even explain the purposes of the church, we have the fivefold ministry. But without additions to the family of God, we cannot substantiate ourselves. When you look back at the true purpose of the church, it's to herald the good news and for others to come into the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. Without that heralding, you and I wouldn't believe, because we would have never had a preacher come for us to hear the good news that Jesus is alive, that Jesus died for us on Calvary's cross. He was buried and raised the third day. We would have never heard the gospel. And without preachers, they never will. For faith comes by hearing, and the hearing of the word of God. This is not by osmosis. Salvation does not come to us through the elect only. Remember now, whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Amen.
But on the other side of that same threshold, we then read, from the foundations of the earth, the elect have been selected. We believe, we proclaim, and that is our responsibility. We are the bride of Christ, to share to a lost and dying world that Jesus lives. You know, right now, nobody will tell you, but I have some ducks sitting up in the baptistry right now. Right. Somebody's saying, why are there ducks floating in this baptistry? Because it doesn't bring about any kind of homage, or this is a very solemn occasion. But I've watched men and women in their baptistry and never smile. I'm looking at a congregation right now, and I'm glad some of you now are smiling, because God lives within us.
Amen.
This has been a celebrated day. I have prayed for this. I shared with you in prayer meeting. We prayed for one baptism. Why one? Because now we can pray for the next one.
Amen.
And the next one. It comes by one and one alone. And this is the joy we have. I was asking people, Miss June, I said, hey, look up in the records when our last baptism was. Tentatively, it was 3 years before Chris left. That's 6 years ago. That puts a smile on my face, because the Lord found us worthy to add to our numbers. Let us continue to be obedient unto Him, and let us celebrate this resurrection day. We call it Easter. Scripture calls it the resurrection of Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Whether it was the cosmos and the placement of the moon is irrelevant, because Scripture doesn't speak of Easter. It speaks of the resurrection, and that's why we gather every with the fellowship of born-again believers to salute and praise and worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm so glad there's smiles in the room now. And if you don't have one, I'll be glad to shake your hand, and then you'll wonder if you have the corona or not. But I want you to know too, it is by your efforts that we're here. And we've experienced such a blessing as today. Come on, go. guy's going to fall over. I'm sorry. Number 8, Mr. Billings. Did I talk so long you went to sleep? Number 8 on the resurrection. The amplifier on?
Yeah. Did I say it is? Well, this is not working. But
is the power switch up on the top right on? For the whole center? Here's what we're going to do. Choir, I'm going to ask you to take the candles out. If you would, Ms. Mark, you take the piano. We're going to move right ahead and we're going to start with, well, something's going on, but we're going to go ahead and start with some hymns. And I'm going to ask you, if you would, to take out your hymnals. We don't have our projector set up yet. Take out your hymnals if you would.
Thank God.
Thank you.
Christ the Lord is risen today. 159.